Rego Records presents Paddy Noonan's Let's Have an Irish Party. Hosted by Carmel Quinn, starring Anna McGoldrick, Barley Bree, Richie O'Shea, the Reagan Family Dancers, and Paddy Noonan's band, featuring Kenny McCloud, Brian McGeogh, Johnny Hanley, and John Trotter. So, let's have an Irish party.
Welcome to our party. In Ireland, we call it a hooly, a do, or just a great night out, whatever you want to call it. There's no party like an Irish party, and there's no music like Paddy Noonan, so let's have an Irish party.
Sing, Irishmen, sing. The sound of your voices will ring. We will let the world know. So say, Irishmen, say, I dream of that beautiful picture. No more we'll think of the past. They'll be singing and dancing in all Ireland, and our people be happy at last. The sound of the gunfire is missing. The rifles will bring no more pain. To see that sunshine over Ireland, and our people are happy again. Sing, Irishmen, sing. The sound of your voices will ring. We will let the world know it really is so. Sing, Irishmen, sing. Our eyes, they shine like the diamond. You'll think she was queen of the land, and her hair hung over her shoulder, tied up with a black velvet band. As I went the walking down Broadway, not intending to stay very long, I met with this frolicsome damsel as she came tipping along. Oh, what she pulled out of her pocket, she placed it right into me hand. Then the law came and sent me to prison, away to that diamond's land. Her eyes, they shone like the diamonds, you'd think she was queen of the land. And her hair hung over her shoulder, tied up.
I've been a wild rover for many a year, and I spent all my money on whiskey and beer. But now I'm returning with gold and grey song, and I never will play the wild rover no more. And it's no day never, no day never no more. went into an alehouse I used to frequent. And I told the landlady my money was spent. I asked her for credit, she answered me nay. Such a customer as yours I can't have any day. And it's no
Dublin's own, Carmel Quinn, America's First Lady of Irish Song.
I've met some folk who say that I'm a dreamer, and I've no doubt there's truth in what they say. But sure, a body's bound to be a dreamer when all the things he loves are far away, and precious things are dreams unto an exile. They take him o'er the land across the sea, especially when it happens he's an exile. And when the moonlight peeps across the rooftops of this great city, so wondrous though it be, I scarcely fear its wonder or its laughter. I'm once again back home in Inishbreek. I wandered o'er green hills through dreamy valleys, and I find a peace no other land could know. I hear the birds make music fit for angels, and I watch the rivers laughing as they flow. But dreams don't last, the dreams are not forgotten, and soon I'm back to stern reality. And though they'll pave the footways all with gold dust, I'll always love my Isle of Inishbreek.
Oh, what a
great party this is. You know something? I have a song you can all help me with. Here's what we do. Every time I sing, don't bother to knock. You clap like that, right? Why don't you try it again? Don't bother to knock. Oh, I love it. Oh, God, it's gorgeous. Okay, we're ready. Have you ever met to Riley's place outside a ballet dog? They say he has the finest still that ever brewed the stock. If you like to drink the Mountain Dew, I'll go there any day. And if Riley hears you coming, he would lift his voice and say, don't bother to knock. Don't bother to knock. Just lift the latch and walk right in, my boy. Don't bother to knock. Don't bother to knock. Come in and make yourself at home. Well, the quality of Riley's brew led quickly to his fame. For soon the locals are hinging tumble to his game. For the Optimum is bicycle and he rolled down Riley's way. And to his most officious knock he heard O'Reilly say, don't bother to knock. Don't bother to knock. Just lift the latch and walk right in, me boy. Don't bother to knock. Don't bother to knock. Come in and make yourself at home. Well, when Riley went before the judge, he thought he'd just be fine. But it turned out that Riley's judge was not the drinking kind. He packed Riley off to jail with very small a day. And when Riley reached the prison gate, he heard the warden say, don't bother to knock. Don't bother to knock. Just lift the latch and walk right in the door. Don't bother to knock. Don't bother to knock. Come in and make yourself at home. Well, sure, that's the life for Riley and his very pleasant end. They say that up in heaven he's St. Patrick's greatest friend. Cause Riley through the grove the snakes from Erin's lovely shore. That's why this Irish welcome is for you on every door. Don't bother to knock. Don't bother to knock. Come in the drink and walk right in, my boys. Don't bother to knock. Don't bother to knock. Come in and make yourself at home.
Oh, God, you're having a good time. How are you, Pat? Are you enjoying yourself? How are you, Paul?
I'm fine.
Are you Oh, she's great.
I'm glad to hear that.
Are you enjoying yourself?
Sure I am.
Sure, we might as well enjoy ourselves. God knows when we'll get out again. You know something? I bet you like to sing.
Indeed I do.
Are you good?
I'm very good.
And he's modest. Oh, God, he's modest. I tell you, all Irishmen love to sing. That's a fact. Yeah. But no Irishman sings like Richie O'Shea.
I was 18 years old when I went down to Dublin with a fistful of money and a cartload of dreams. Take your time, said me father, stop rushing like hell, and remember all is not what it seems to be. For this fellas will cut you for the colt on your back, for the watch that you got from your mother. So take care, me young bucko, and mind yourself well, and will you give this wee note to me brother? At the time Uncle Benji was a policeman in Brooklyn, me father the youngest looked after the farm. When a phone call from America to send the lad over, should the young fella said it wouldn't do any harm. For I spent my life working this dirty old ground, for a few pints of porter and the smell of a pound. I should maybe there's something you learned I see, and you can bring it back home, make it easy on me. So I landed at Kennedy, and a big yellow taxi carried me and me bags through the streets and the rain. Oh, my poor heart was thumping around with excitement, and I hardly even heard what the driver was saying. We came in the Shore Parkway to the flatlands in Brooklyn, to my uncle's apartment on East 53rd. I was feeling so happy, I was humming a song, and I sang, "You're as free as a bird." But to shorten my story, what I found out that day, that Benji got shot down in an uptown parade. And while I was flying my way to New York, poor Benji was lying in a cold city morgue. Well, I phoned up the old fella, told him the news. I knew he could hardly stand up in his shoes. And he wept and he said, "Go ahead with the plans, and not to forget, be a proud Irishman." So I went up to Nelly's beside Farham Road, and I started to learn about lifting the load. But the heaviest thing that I carried that year was the bittersweet thoughts of my hometown so dear. I went home that December, 'cause the old fella died, and to borrow the money from a pal on the site. And all the bright flowers and brass couldn't hide the poor wasted face of me father. I sold up the old farmyard for what it was worth, and into me bag stuck a handful of earth. And I boarded a train, and I caught me a plane, and I found myself back in the U.S. again. It's been 22 years since I set foot in Dublin. The kids know to use the correct knife and fork. But I'll never forget the green grass and the rivers as I keep law and order in the streets of New York. Da 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 da.
Is a party, especially an Irish party, without authentic Irish dancing? Well, wait till you see the dancers we have at our party, the champions of North America, the Reagan family. Thank you. this is a little poem. It's a very old poem. I don't know how old, but old. It's about a little boy and his first day at school. I suppose all mothers, including myself, remember the first day your little boy goes to school. You have all sorts of mixed feelings. You know, you're delighted he can go, but you're sad that he's going. It's the first pull away from you. And you're happy that he's happy about going, but you're sad that he's that happy. You know, why isn't he a little sad about leaving? I don't know. It's all mixed feelings. And this poem is about a little fella called Hugh. His mother called him Wee Huey. He's gone to school, Wee Huey, and him just four. Oh, I saw the fright was in him when he left the cabin door. But he took a hand of Dinny and he took a hand of Dan, and with Joe's old coat upon him, the poor wee man. He cut the queerest figure, he looked more stout than thin, and trotting nice and steady with his toes turned in. I followed to the corner of the owl turf stack, and the more his feet went forward, the more his head turned back. He was looking. Would I call him? And oh, my heart was full of woe. For 'tis lost I'll be without him. But you know, he has to go. I followed round the corner, and when he passed it by, oh God help him, he was crying. And you know, so was I. Paddy, that was beautiful, you know. Brought back a lot of wonderful memories. Guess who's coming to town? They just arrived in town. They're going to give us a preview of their show. They're really from Donegal and Tyrone. Let's give a big welcome to the Barley Bree.
Here's an old traditional tune this time called The Hen's March. Thank you. America. We were in New York City, and we took a little walk up around Central Park there. And it's unbelievable. The place is full of joggers from morning to night. Thousands of joggers, all shapes and sizes. And it brought a little song to mind, which we're going to sing for you now. And we're going to teach you all the chorus, and then you sing back to us. And the words of the chorus say, "Come on, Harry, and come on, Sue. We're going to do what the magazines tell us to. We're going to get ourselves in shape the fashionable way. 25 laps around the pond will make us tall and thin and blonde. So hand me down me jogging shoes today." I was out for a stroll, I was walking the pub, checking the scene, seeing what was up. I wasn't bothering no one, I was easing on down the road. When all of a sudden came a pity, pity pat, I said, "Good Lordy, tell me, what is that?" I turned to look and my brain took an overload. Around the trail and along the pond came a thousand people with their underwear on, picking them up and laying them down like mad. Puffing and groaning, faces all red, eyes rolled back and each sweaty head. I never saw so many people look so bad. And they said, "Come on, Harry, come on, Sue. We're going to do what the magazines tell us to. We're going to get ourselves in shape the fashionable way. 25 laps around the pond will make us tall and thin and blonde. So hand me down the jogging shoes today." Well, now the noise was strictly rolling thunder. The jog took off with his tail tucked under, stood by the side of the road to watch them pass. Their shirts were nicely understated, they all looked terribly dedicated. Some looked strong, some looked low on gas. Well, there were some that were built like landlocked waves, some wore shorts from blooming days, some had legs that looked like 6 feet long. Well, they had clearly come to do or die, and as that herd went thundering by, so help me folks, they all broke into song. And they said, "Come on, Harry, come on, Sue, we're going to do what the magazines tell us to. We're going to get ourselves in shape the fashionable way. 25 laps around the pond will make us tall and thin and blonde. So hand me down my jogging shoes today." I knew they'd all succeed or bust. I knew by the size of that cloud of dust. I knew by the sound of the blisters going crack. I thought I'd head back to the barn. Suddenly somebody grabbed my arm. There I was in the middle of that seething pack. I was sweating like a fool, I was out of breath, trying to stop from being stomped to death. I must have been an edifying sight to see. I cried, "Folks, you may jeer and scoff, but my legs are broken, they're falling off." Then you know what they turned and they said to me. Here's what they said. Well, they said, "Come on, Harry, come on, Sue, we're gonna do what the magazines tell us to. We're gonna get ourselves in shape the fashionable way. 25 laps around the pond will make us tall and thin and blonde. So hand me down my jogging shoes today." And they said, "Come on, Harry, come on, Sue, we're gonna do what the magazines tell us to. We're gonna get ourselves in shape the fashionable way. 25 laps around the pond will make us tall and thin and blonde. So hand me down my jogging shoes today. Yes, I said, hand me down my jogging shoes today." There was a wild colonial boy, Jack Dubin was his name. He was born and reared in Ireland, in a place called Cal.
You know, every once in a while, I have the rare privilege to introduce somebody that I have always admired. She is a great talent, a wonderful lady, the pride of Ireland, and especially the pride of Monaghan, a great singer, Miss Anna McGoldrick.
Well, this is probably the best known Irish song of all. It's the beautiful Derriere. They say that the words are those of a mother to her last son as he goes to war, and it's called Danny Boy. Oh, Danny Boy, the pipes are calling. From glen to glen and down the mountainside, the summer's gone and all the roses falling. Tis you must go, and I must bide. But come ye back when summer's in the meadow, or when the valley's hushed and white with snow. Tis I'll be here in sunshine or in shadow. Oh, Danny Boy, I love you This next song is a very special song for me. It was written in memory of a very fine Irishman. His father and mother came from County Monaghan, my own county. The song was written in memory of James Connolly. Outside of Kilmainham, with our heads all uncovered, they knelt on the ground. Inside that grim prison, a brave Irish hero, his life for his country to lay down. He went to his death like a true Irish soldier, and the firing party he proudly did face till the order rang out. Going round down in a corner of me heart, a loving spot you found, and every time I gaze into your Irish eyes of blue, they seem to whisper, darling boy, my heart belongs to you. Oh, Barley, my Irish Barley, my sweet. change your name, go on, be game, be gara, and I'll do the same, my Irish Molly. Here I furnished up the flat. Three little cozy rooms with bath and welcome on the mat. £5 down and £2 per week, we'll soon be out of debt. It's all complete, except they haven't brought the cradle yet. Oh, Marley, my Irish Dolly, my sweet Hampish lady, I'm fairly off my drawing. When you were near springtime, springtime, you know it's springtime. Come there, now don't be slow. Change your name, go on, be game, be gara, and I'll do the same. My Irish Molly, did you hear what all the neighbours say about the 100 sovereigns you have safely stowed away? They say that's why I love you. Now isn't that a shame? If you had only 99, I'd love you just the same. Oh, Marley, my Irish Molly, my sweet Acushna dear, I'm fairly off my trolley. When you are near springtime, springtime, you know it's springtime. Come there, now don't be slow. Change your name, go on, be game, be gara, and I'll do the same. My Irish Molly,
just a man. Help me believe in what I should be and all that I am. Show me the stairway I have to climb. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking of you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a time. Do you remember when you walked among men? Well, Jesus, you know, if you're looking below, it's worse now than then. They're pushing and shoving, so pardon my mind. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine.
help me today. Show me the way. One day at a time. The parlor has a welcome there for you. And if your name is Timothy, a pack as long as you come from Ireland, there's a welcome on the mat. If you come from the mounts of Moran, Killarney's lake so blue, we'll sing a song, we'll make a fuss. Whoever you are, you're one of us. You're Irish, this is the place for you.
Come into the parlor now and make yourselves at home. Come into the parlor, sure you won't be on your own. This big McGinnis, right for King, and this Murphy will do. They say McGilligan's daughter doesn't know the taste of water. There's gates that stop the second out and there's room for half the town. Bottles of the water if you want to wash it down. And if you're Irish, you're sure of a welcome. There's a hoolie out at Halligan's house tonight.
Weddings, boys, to every fancy hall. And when we play for funerals, we play a march of song. All the drums go bang, the cymbal clang, and the horn is blaring. Be happy with the orphans, whom all Ireland's pipes to play. Hennessy, fancy, tools, and flute, the music is something grand. For credit to all Ireland, be back the Maris band.
Today we sat from out the car. I wonder if from O'Hara's while I landed in New York. There wasn't a soul to greet me there, a stranger on the shore. But Irish luck was with me here, and fortune came galore. Now that I'm gone back again to dear old Ireland's Isle, my friends will meet me on the pier and greet me with a smile. Their faces sure I almost forgot, for I've been so long away. Me mother will introduce them all, and this to me she'll say. Shake out to dear Uncle Mike, me boy, and here's your sister Kate. There's a girl who used to swing down by the garden gate. Shake hands with all the neighbors, kiss the cottings all. You're welcome as a pleasant maid, your dear old Donegal.
A great time. Yay! Okay, well, all good things have to end sometime. Aww. Well, yes. And what better way to end it all than we all sing together?
Yes.
Oh,